I fixed it!
I don't know if you noticed, but last episode, well, no, the one before that, I said I broke the temperature probe, so I got a new one. So hopefully tomorrow I'll be able to do a print. No promises, it's really cold. It's like 32 right now, I can see my breath. And got a few other things, but I did say I plan to do an unboxing, but I got carried away. I opened it inside. I didn't even get it out here and where I could take a video of it. Oh yeah, and if you're wondering where I got the new thermistor, I got it from Maker Geeks. So, yeah. That's where I got it. But I'm gonna go over a little bit of what I got. Like, my aunt took this physical computing class, so I got a lot of her stuff, like breadboards, random components, clip leads. I really like these ones. Then I got these battery clips. Then this... Oh, where did I put it? Oh. This wall plug that comes out and has the exact same connector as a 9-volt battery. So that's why I have these plugs on the breadboard. And then I got a whole bunch of solder. I got a new soldering iron, but I don't need it. Clearly, this thing and like these other two, that one. I have too many soldering irons. I also did get like a ruler, this vise, and I'm so happy about this. The helping hands. I wouldn't have been able to get that on the printer without this. Took too long. And my new favorite wire strippers. I am going way too fast. I realize this. But about a week ago, I got this, and I've been hopefully going to do a reviewing on it, but I didn't do an unboxing. It works nice, just don't suck up too much solder, it will clog. Because my method was add a little more solder to act as something to carry heat. Yeah, it will clog this. And already on the inside, the spring is covered in solder. Then I recently found my old drill for my PCB boards. I love this thing. It's amazing. It's old. Don't know where you're going to get one, but it can make a hole wider. So I use it frequently. I also got a whole bunch of, oh crap, let's open, of these. So I plan to use these to make things go on breadboard or possibly a shield for my Arduino. Ton of zip ties. I got a lot of. I'm kind of upset that I got a lot of wire. I mean, I have too much wire. Just too much. I did get some Ethernet cables, which I didn't need, so this is Ethernet. Also my favorite wire to work with, but really hard to strip until I got these. So, quick update. I haven't even tested this yet. I forgot to mention that. But I am working on some other projects I'll hopefully get to do a video of. I also got a ton of project box, so I plan to use these. And hopefully I can get rid of some of this wire and LEDs and heat shrink. I got a lot's been going on, even though I haven't been able to do videos of it. I did take apart a walkie-talkie. I didn't even plan what I was going to do for this video. I just felt like I hadn't done a real video in a while. So, that's what I'm doing. And for everyone that doesn't know this, the reason I have a big board out of a TV here is most of my components are salvaged. I'm not really a green recycling person, but I do salvage most of my components. Like, these are out of things. These aren't salvaged, but 90% of my components in here are salvage. And this is a box of components I didn't salvage. And this is things I built in the past. And I did get a lot. I also got a whole other box of stuff. There isn't a lot in here. It's stuff I already had. I got some plugs. Whatever. Hopefully I'll do something that runs on 110. Rosin paste, I should use this. I'm surprised no one's called me out on that yet. I don't ever use that stuff. But I really want to make more videos. I don't know what you guys want to see. So I've just been doing what I can, when I can. And I really do want to do more with the 3D printer, and I am still trying to build one. I'm working with a friend right now to build a carriage. You know, this part where the head slides back and forth and goes up and down, forward and back. I didn't raise it because I don't feel like twisting the lead screws. But I never did show around my toolbox, so anything that you squeeze is in here. Because I really don't know what this is. I think it's a wire cutter. So I did want to show this off, but so I guess I'll do that now. Oh, dang. Look at that. These are clippers I use in my 3D printer, and look. It's so cold out, it's actually freezing the rubber. This is actually usually a soft rubber, but it's, like, freezing over. It must mean there's moisture in my toolbox. Oh. Is that a bad thing? If there's moisture in here, I mean, my tools are probably gonna rust. Yep, rust. But just all my screwdrivers and security screws are over there. Just electronic stuff. Then just, this is a bin of salvage parts I have yet to organize. This is leads and scrap PCB, eh. And then we have my old solder stand. This is for this iron when I got it. Then we have this little multimeter. It does one thing. Why did I call it a multimeter? And then down here we have all my other tools. I don't want to go through all this stuff because this woodworking and stuff. Scrap wire. I'm really just picking up on the tour to workshop I never did. But then we have my jumper leads. Filament for printer. My blue glow-in-the-dark ABS back there. Just random parts, screws, jumper leads, I already said those. That magnifying glass you can melt things with. Really, I just have it on two of those clamps on those milk crates back there. And I'm able to melt and burn things with it. Not this time of year, though. But this video is more of just a rant than anything else. I feel I'm doing more of these vlogs than actual projects, and I want to do that. It's just I don't have the projects to do. So I need ideas of stuff I can build. I'm not a creative person. I'm really not. But I do salvage components, and I mentioned that in mine. I'm just going off right now. Go for the rest of the toolbox, I guess. And we have my dial caliper. That's a screwdriver. 6-volt driver. Various tools. My electric paint. Why is this in here? It's part of a TV. Did I drill into this or something? I had plans for it, I guess. Little knife I was trying to sharpen. This bell thing is a bunch of Allen wrenches. Zip ties. This is a computer power supply. Why is this so far back? I can't even have the lid open. Those are hospital clips because my stepmom's a nurse. And then they're actually really helpful for when you're soldering something and you need to hold wires on. Ah, crap. Just, they melt too easily. Oh, hey. My little normally closed relay. I like relays. Switchboard I obviously didn't do anything with. Oh, look, it's a safety switch. I'm trying to keep myself from turning something on. Computer fan. Fan controller board. Why do I just have a random clip here? Screwdrivers. This video really hasn't decided when it wants to be. Is it a tour? Is it a project? Is it an update? I don't know. But Then we have, oh, yeah, this. Because why not? But this is just my shop. Oh, yeah, this. Hold on. Hard to turn a key one-handed. Oh, it's not. But. Radiation in use. Everyone needs one of these. Oh. Did that myself. And we have, of course, Surface Mount Lab. Do I need to say anything? Oh yeah, I tried to make a really big paracord braid. Because why not? I'm just gonna call this video shop tour slash anything else I can think of. Because, well, I haven't made up my mind what I want this to be. I just needed to get a video out there, and I haven't done one. It's a lot longer than my normal videos. It's I don't know what it is, but I am working on getting some more things to do teardowns. I should mention that. Because I just like tearing things apart. As you can see, I have boards everywhere. The reason I like tearing it apart is I get components out of it, and I get to make a video of it. Though I never think to. I'm also thinking about doing how-tos, but I think that's a little useless. Just gonna put my thing away. Oh. I don't know if you've seen this before, but this is why I'm not good at 3D modeling. Tried to make a little Luger. Yeah, I made it way too small. I don't know how I even managed to do this. It fits on top of a penny, really. I mean, a good thing for reference would be this resistor. It's small. It's really small. But, like, just tell me what you guys want to see, and I'll see what I can do. Maybe I'll build something with components I salvaged, or I have a lot of perf board. I could do that, but I can do a lot of this. I can prototype now. So just tell me what you guys want to see, and I can try to do it. I really want to. I want to do this. I just, like I said, I'm not creative. Really not. But I'm also thinking about most helpful tools and stuff like that. Anything I can do to help people get started with this as a hobby, or maybe even try to make their job out of it. That's what I'm trying to do. But if there's something you want to see me do, a project, a build, a teardown, or something, if I can get the materials to do it, yeah, I'll try it. So, thank you guys for watching, and maybe, oh, it's 13 minutes, I can't have that. Maybe next time. It's 13 minutes, can't have that. Mask it.